Yeah, here we are.
Yeah, so I've had enough of this cigarette. I can tell when I have enough because it's just not the same relaxing feeling anymore. It's more like the You get the first few puffs off it, and it's like, it just every once in a while. Like, once or twice a month, you know? Some lady gave this to me. It's the Holy Grail, man. That was the universe letting me know the Holy Grail's coming. And that's the International Bank. And there's a sign of nature. I heard a car just rev by. I've studied. Holy Grail. She dropped it on the ground. It all cracked. So I just said, all you got to do is glue it back together. So she said, eh. She left it on the ground. I said, huh? I'll take it if you don't want it. She says, well, it must have been meant for you. So I could tell she was in tune to the spirit. She knows all about these things. It was meant for you. Yeah, she knows. And I got the heart right here. This is from a old man who used to live around here. He died a couple years ago, but he left this in my yard for me. And he was real friendly with everybody. He was a friendly old man. Kind of reminded me of myself, because that's the way I am. I'm friendly with everyone, man. I'll talk to anybody. I don't care if you're retarded or not. If you're a drunk, druggy, whatever. I'll sit down and I'll talk with you. If you're rich, if you're middle class, if you're poor, I'll talk with you. I ain't got no qualms to be seen around town with you, talking in front of the public, in front of everybody else. Ain't no big deal. In fact, it's needed. So. But I do go through my periods where I just want to be by myself, where I don't want to talk to nobody, so. But more and more that I get my freedom and access to that bank account, you know, it's going to be like not a big deal. Because you can speak the truth to everybody. All everybody wants to know is the truth. And when everybody knows the truth, they're on equal footing. And then they can study to get to where, you know, to move up the pyramid. It's all equal. That's the name of the game, man. But back in the old days, they had to refrain from telling the truth because the truth persecuted. People will be burnt at the stake for telling the truth. That all has to do with their thoughts, though. If they would have told themselves they weren't going to get persecuted, it wouldn't have happened. But they told themselves, oh, we're being persecuted. Oh, we got to go into hiding. See? And that's just law of attraction. It brings more persecution right back on. You understand these things. Now, we have all this history we can look back upon and say, oh, I see how it works. Saying, I need to get a drink of water. Hold on. Got me a sucker so I'd get that tobacco taste out of my mouth.
How to do a new tanky tink? Zip, clear, pack it.
So here I am, just sitting with my thoughts, watching my thoughts go by. You know, my thoughts are telling me, it ain't gonna work, it ain't gonna work, this is gonna go around, that's gonna go around. I just watch them go by. I'll acknowledge him and say, oh, well, I see you. But, no, things are going to turn out just right. You sinking feeling coming down upon me that wants to make things go wrong, you cannot collect from my health, from my well-being, unless you pay me $750 billion, you corporate thought. That's all these thoughts are. They're corporate thought. Think about this. I'm gonna put together a university full of reading material and educational films and videos to teach people how to master their thoughts and how to catch their thoughts and all the corporate dressings that they come in. A university. Yeah. And it's going to be a public university full of private knowledge. This whole earth is going to evolve because of this man right here. He's going to set the pace, who ain't going to die. I ain't dying. I understand what that Clamoleen has done for me. It is my ticket to the eternal life. Death cannot claim me anymore. Death is just another word for the corporation. Remember, the corporation is an entity. It's dead. Because all it is just words on a paper. Rules and regulations on a paper. Because that's all they do, is they show you a piece of paper in court and say, hey, you broke the rule that's on this paper. Well, can this paper speak for itself, judge? Does it have a pulse? Did the paper sign on itself? Did I sign the paper also? Is there an agreement there between me and the paper? The paper can't sign. You know, I'm not saying we have to talk to the judge like that. I'm just acting right now. You know, my own private acting. But that's what it comes down to. Prison Planet is just rules on a paper. But they're needed. It's needed. Why is it needed? Because it got us out of the jungle where everyone was killing each other. So some smart men led by Mother Nature and Father Cause decided, whoa, we got to come up with a plan. And the plan was to build cities that had rules written on stone tablets. And then we evolved to paper. These were some smart men who thought up these prison systems. All these prison systems were built out of necessity. Otherwise, we'd still be killing each other in the jungles. If it wasn't for the entity known as the corporation, which represents something that's dead, words on paper. If it wasn't for the corporation, words on paper, we'd still be killing each other in the jungles. Think on those things. Think about the necessity of the system that we have called Prison Planet, that the United States is the law enforcement gun from the tribe of Judah, King David, who Mother Nature anointed to rule the planet with a fist and a gun so that people could learn how to be peaceful and safe. And be self-responsible without no more rules on a paper. It's all written on their heart. That's what the true nature of the Bible is. The evolution of mankind killing each other to being put under rules so they can write these rules on their heart naturally. Without words on paper, it's just a natural instinct. Oh, This is the peaceful way, out of gut feeling and instinct. I know that it's best just to maintain myself peacefully with other people and to be safe. Not to run through the stop signs without stopping, that's unsafe. Not to be building a bomb in your backyard that you ain't qualified to know what's going on with those chemicals you're making and electronics. You're going to blow someone up. That's unsafe. If you have not fully studied at a universal level in legal public schools about how chemicals go together, how atoms can split, and you're out there in your backyard playing around with atoms, and you ain't got the slightest idea how to be safe about using those things, that's not safe, man. Now your neighbors are going to be like, oh, what's this dude doing? God. Yeah. Think about that. Now apply that to every instant in life. Everything you can think of that's unsafe. Think about it. What is your conscience telling you? Sure, you're going to go overboard, but you need to go overboard so you can say, oh, okay, well, this ain't working. Let me set a new desire. Going overboard just provides contrast. Contrast is just being uncomfortable. Your adrenaline starts to rush. You start becoming apathetic, unresponsible. That's unsafe. You got someone asking you a question, you don't respond to them, and now that person's all pissed off because you didn't want to respond to the person. So that person goes down the street, punches someone out because he's pissed, or he runs across the street and causes two cars to crash into each other because he's all mad and angry and fouled out of shape because you didn't want to respond to him because you caused a liability to happen in the public. Because you didn't know what being safe was all about. Liability is just a behavior that's out of control. Now, sure, you're going to make some mistakes in here and there, but the point is, learn from them. Use those mistakes as contrast. In other words, something you can have as a backing board to say, okay, let me bounce off of that and come over here to what's more safe. See what I'm saying? Yeah. So there's three stages to humanity. The kill world of the jungle, prison planets under rules, written on paper, dead entity corporation rules, corporate rules. But they're still good. It's just that they're dead, though. So when you evolve past that and put your claim of lien on the corporation, they have no hold over you no more. Because you know how to be self-regulating. You are a peacemaker now. And Mother Nature will regulate and say, okay, you are a peacemaker. And she will cause things to happen for you, such as getting your bank account trust. Yeah. Remember, it's not all about what you can prove before man. It's all about what you can prove before mama. Mama and Dada. Dada is just your thoughts up here in the Most High, the cerebrum. This earth that we live in, the sun, the moon, the stars, the air, the planet, the water, everything. The fire that we see, everything. The wind. It's all female. It's the cerebell. It's all the lower brain. So all of the whole universe represents the lower brain. Because it's tangible, manifested evidence we can see and feel and touch and taste, smell, hear. We see the sun shining. We feel it beating on its heat on us. That's all female. It's the cerebell. It represents the bottom brain, the lower brain, the animal brain. The brain that has to be tamed. If you don't tame the sun, it's going to come too close to the earth and burn us all up. You understand that? Now, how do you tame it? With thought. Father thought. It's our Most High. It's our thought that regulates Mother Earth. Yeah. Think about those things, man. Everything on this In this whole universe, which is female, runs from the male. It's influenced by the male, called thought.
Ah, Bruglis! Yeah! Here, here! You call him Bruglis! That little bug! How about like a Pokemon? Pads! And Bruglis! Yeah! Hi to Bruglis! Ah, Pokemon!
That's my leading male cat, man. He's my best friend cat. Teaching my other cats how to be best friends too, but he's the one that's already matured into being learn how to be a best friend, huh, bud?
Our best friend. Our best friend. Why don't you be nice to me? Otherwise, I might have to scratch you. Put your bite. Oh, Hippo, Winnie Poop. That funny little bunny. Heck yeah, I put butt screen, man. Sniff my butt. It smells like butt, man. Nothing wrong with butt. We all smelled some butt before. We know what butt smells like. Ain't no shame smelling some butt.
My little butt. I'm my little friend. Yeah. He's all purring and everything. He loves this. As long as I be gentle with him, he's the happiest little guy. If I pet him too hard or pet him in a spot he don't want to be pet, he not in the mood to be pet, he'll let me know. Oh, but it's true.
Yeah, I'll let you know, man. I'll let you know.
There he is, a little buddy. This is Judah Jr. That's Brenda Chiba Jr.
Yeah, Brenda Chiba Jr., man. Chiba Jr. Friendly little guy, friendly. That's your friendly, I drool.
Who?
Mm-hmm.
He gets all carried away, feeling so good in purr heaven. He starts to drool, man. It's like, oh, yeah. Ha, 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 ha. Bud, bud.
Feeling good, feeling good.
And my little friend.
I would say, just be gentle with me. That's all I ask. Now you're gentle and you're good to go.
He especially likes his head rubbed and petted. It's like, oh, yeah. Feel good. I like to stroke my head. Down to the shoulders, about the middle of his back. You start petting him down below. He doesn't like that too much. Not bud.
Yeah, I'm working on it, though. Yeah. I'm trying to get better.
Little friend, him a little friend, huh?
Yeah, a little friend.
So I have to give him some attention. I realize that when I give him the attention when he needs it, he's happy. He's a happy little guy. And he doesn't fight with the other cats. As I give him the attention he needs, well, I ignore him and don't give him all the attention he needs, he starts to fight. He gets all angry and mad.
What the hell? You watching too much? You doing too many videos. You need to spend some time with me.
So, you know how it is. It ain't no different from having kids, man. You don't spend time, equal time with your kids, man. You're on the video all the time and you're not spending time with your kids. Also, well, that's no balance. No balance. There's an out of balance, man. Your kids will start lacking attention, so they'll start doing stuff, you know, harmful stuff to themselves and to the public. Think about that. I got a little radiator heater down there. It looks pink right now, but it's actually red. It's just the angle from the camera. But it is red. I got my shoes and socks in front of it. So, you know, my mind's starting to go into thoughts about power, you know. Well, what am I going to do if I run out of power, you know? Well, maybe I should go down to Catholic Community Services, but they wouldn't pay for water, so what, should I start selling stuff to pay for water, you know? This is all future projection, man. This isn't in the moment of now. So I have to tell those thoughts, whoa, brain, put some reins on it, lower brain. That's the animal brain, man, going off into the future. So I got to come back to now. What's happening now? Nice cats are going and having a good time on the video. I got the walls around I can look at. Got my guitars over there. I'm talking on the video. This is now. See? Start dwelling on the past. Start projecting into the future. That's worry. You know, guilt of the past, fears of the past, worry of the future, fear of the future. Oh my God. Break out of it. Boom. Whoa. Damn. I lost myself. Holy shit. There's a wall right here. There's walls around me. There's a floor. There's lights. There's an app behind me. There's a cat there. This is life. This is now. We start getting lost in thought. It's like ourselves are going like and turning into paper print rules. Paper print rules are nothing about how to regulate worries and fears and stuff like that. You know, or it defines what fear and worry is. Words on paper, and it's just death. Definitions are just death. There are no definitions in reality of everything. Everything just is. It doesn't need a name, doesn't need a definition. It just is. Everything in the natural world and the natural laws of the universe just is. It's a law of cause and effect. It's a law of agreement, law of correspondence, as above, so below. The law of gender, there's a male and female side to everything. The law of rhythm. The law of polarity. So, you know. Yeah. All these things help us to... These are the real world of what's happening right now. Start getting lost in thought. Now it's lost in thought is just representation of definitions and names on paper. That's death. That's corporation. Corpse. Corporation. Corps. The job corps. The Marine Corps. Any other corps. Corporation. Everything's a corps. Everything. Walmart is a corps. The Walmart corps. The hospital corps. The county court corps. It's all the same thing. Corporation. Just words and definitions on paper to define. But it's needed. It's an evolutionary step that's needed. Bring us out from the killer kill be world of the jungle. But we're to evolve past that. That's what the Mayan shift was. To go into universal law, private maritime law, put a lien on our bodies so nothing can collect from it. That includes poverty, sickness, health, or poverty, sickness, disease, sorrow, sadness, anger, fear. All those things are trying to collect from our well-being of life, pursuit of happiness, joy, love, fulfillment, desires, everything you could name that's on the positive side of polarity. So we want a balance between the two. So we just watch those thoughts go by. All those sadness thoughts, just watch them. Don't pull out your wallet and show your ID card to your thoughts of sadness and fear and anger. Because once you do that, your thoughts will say, oh, you're under my jurisdiction. Now I'm going to attach an emotion to you. Sink into fear. Worry. Oh, how am I going to pay the bills? Oh, I got the power turned on. Oh, shit. What if they turn it off on me? Oh, my bank account's overdrawn. Oh, shit. I ain't got my account yet. Huh? See? Pull yourself out. Whoa! There's a wall here. There's a cat here. There's a floor here. There's a ceiling. There's Mother Nature outside. There's trees. There's air. There's a heater going. It's nice and warm. I'm feeling good. My back's aching. Let me rub my back to make it feel better. You gotta pull yourself out of it, man. And you gotta remember to pull yourself out of it. You gotta do this time and time again. That's why I say, get on these video cameras, make videos, and practice doing this stuff on videos. And let the public see your videos, who you really are. Let them know what's going on in your mind, man. To the extent that you can. You know, you don't just want to tell them everything that's going on in your mind that you can't handle. If you can handle it, go ahead. If you can handle it, man, do it. If you have to make some mistakes and adjust, and so don't do it again, cancel the video. Put it on private, you know, or something. Oh, shit, I shouldn't have said that. You know. Or don't make the video public yet. Put it on private, watch it first, and then see, I wonder how I can justify that and turn it into good if I need to, you know, to make it turn it into something good so that it's not a public hazard to somebody. and you do the best you can. So that's all that matters, is doing the best we can. That's the one thing about the band Kiss that they have real good going for them when they were together. Just the best, man. We just do the best. Yeah. But you don't want to go overboard on the best, or to where you're just totally striving for perfection, where you're stressed out. You know, if your voice is giving out, sing in the lower registers. Your voice needs a rest. Start singing in the lower registers, then your voice will gain strength back again. You can go back up and sing high again. But you might need to take 3 or 4 or 5 years and sing in the low registers. Swallow your pride, man. Do something different if you have to. If you love to sing, sing low. Swing low, sweet chariot. Mama's gonna bring me home. And then there's always voice lessons. Take voice lessons so you can learn how to sing in those high registers again with proper voice, muscle, tension. Education, man, that's the key. Knowledge. Understanding how the body works, how the voice works, the larynx. So, that was for someone out there. You know who you are. I'm sitting on a bucket. I'll eventually set up my table again so I can rest on the bed here. But here, we got another 30-minute video, so I'll make this a 33-minute for 33 degrees. Maybe not. I'll stop now. I don't feel like waiting.